Welcome to the video lectures of Object-Oriented Design and Programming offered by the Kerala Technology University. Myself Sarju, and in this video lecture we are going to discuss about the fifth module. In fifth module we have two parts, string class and the applet class and implementation. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about the second part of the fifth module, that is about the applet basics. Okay, what is an applet? So Java applet is a small dynamic Java program that can be transferred via the internet and run by a Java compiler, run by a Java compatible web browser. So there is a difference, it's actually a difference from that Java programs we have already learned. There is some difference in Java applet. We'll look into that. And it usually run on, it's usually executed in the applet viewer or Java compatible web browsers. So first look into a small applet program. It's a good applet program. Next we can this is a small applet program, and this applet program I have created will display a small smiley face, a small smiley. Okay, just run it. So the smiley program, we are going to run it to get the correct window. I am giving the size of the window as 500 and 500. Okay, run it. Yeah, that's a cool smiley, right? So I have created a smiley by using the Java applet, and it is viewed on the Java applet viewer. This is the Java applet viewer. So the Java applet programs are usually run in the applet viewer. Okay, and please look at the program. So you wonder about this program that in all the Java programs you have already written as a main program, as a main method, but here we don't have any main method, right? We'll look into the details of that program later. Okay, this is simple a Java applet program which runs a smiley. Yeah, okay, this is smiley displays by the program and it is displayed in the applet viewer. Okay, so that's what we explain. So Java applet program is a small dynamic Java program which can transfer through the internet to any computer web browser, and which is run in the web browser. So before going into the syntax and other details of the applet, just go through a small history of the applet. What is applet? When it is introduced, what is the current status of the applet now? Okay. Actually, the applet was introduced by Sun Microsystem in 1995. Unlike other applications, Java applet could not be run directly by an operating system. Instead, they had to run within Java Runtime Environment, or JRE, or within another program that included Java plugin. So there is a difference in the applet program, right? So that's I already told in the beginning. Because Java applets run within the JRE and were not executed by the operating system, they could run on Windows, Mac, Linux systems. So any operating system can execute these programs. This cross-platform capability made applets useful to web developers who wanted to add functionalities on a web page that HTML could not provide. So all of you know that due to before the introduction of HTML5, we have HTML4 versions used, and HTML4 have limited dynamic functionalities. So in HTML4, we are use this Java applets to add the dynamic functionalities, so add the additional functionalities on the web page. So in the early days of the internet, applets were commonly used to create interactive buttons, checkboxes, forms, and other small animations on websites. To accommodate the use of applets, the HTML4 introduced a tag, and the name of the tag is applet tag. So applet tag is introduced in HTML4 to include these applets in the HTML programs. The tag is invoked. The tag invoked a Java virtual machine JVM plugged into the web browser, and that was accompanied by some parameters specified where and how the applet should display on the website. So this applet tag and the parameter tags together helps the Java web browser to display the Java applets. So plugins offered a way to bring advanced capability to the browser environment without forcing users to install applications locally. If an end user's browser couldn't run Java, it would either skip over the applet tag, or it displays an alternate tag which is specified in the applet tag. When a browser launched the Java applet from a web page, the applet executed within the Java virtual machine and an environment not controlled by the browser developers. That was an issue. So when a program, when a website which contains a Java applet, when the that website is browsed, that Java applet will be automatically loaded into the web browser, and it will run in the Java virtual machine environment, and the web browser developers has very less control on these Java applets. So they don't have any control over the Java applets which is run on the web browser. So this provided to be frustrating for both developers and the end users, as plugins increasingly become targets for security exploits, which in turn required Java to be updated frequently. So lots of security issues came, lots of vulnerabilities happened in form of these applets. So Java needs to update frequently to solve all these issues. So by 2015, most of the browser vendors had either removed or announced their intentions to remove Java plugin support. So in response to this movement, the Oracle deprecated the Java browser plugin in the Java Development Kit 9 in favor of installable applications or alternative technologies such as Java Web Start. So from the JDK 9 onwards, we don't have any support for Java applets. So if you want to run any Java applet program, you have to install the JDK version 8 or downward versions. So you will not get, you will not execute, can't execute the Java applets from the 9 version onwards. Currently we are on the 13th version, so you can't execute any Java applet program in the 13th version. If you want to execute, use the 8 version or below 8. So that's the history of the applet. So actually the history started in 1995 and it's ended on 2015 in between, in Sun Microsystem acquired by the Oracle in 2009. So it was introduced by Sun Microsystem, but it's entered by the Oracle. So nice, right? And some of the important points we have to learn about the Java applets. All the applets are the subclass of java.applet.applet class. So all the applets are the subclass of this applet class, and the applets are not standalone programs as we wrote previously. So they run within either a web browser or an applet viewer. And the one important point I have mentioned in the example, the applet don't have a main method. The applet class will not have a main method. So that's why it is called this. That's why we mentioned these applets programs are not standalone programs. Okay. Then next, the life cycle of an applet. So as we study in thread life cycle in the previous module, similarly we have the applet also have a life cycle. Okay, so let me discuss about the applet life cycle. So let us discuss about this applet life cycle. Okay, so applet life cycle is born, running, idle, and dead. These are the four states of an applet. So let us discuss about each states in detail. Okay, the first is the init method. So the init method, this is the first method invoked when an applet is executed, and all the variable declarations, all the initializations, all are performed within this method. So when we call the init method, actually a Java applet born. Okay, so this is the first method. All the initializations, all the declarations, everything is done in this init method. And the second method in the Java applet lifecycle is start method. The start method, the actual code of the applet which is included in the start method, and it executes immediately after the init method. So when an init method is executed, the applet lifecycle will next execute the start method, similar to the start and run method in the thread program, right? And okay, when this JRE calls this start method, when the applet is restored, applet is maximized, we are moving from one tab to another tab in the browser. So in all these situation, the start method is called. So when the applet window is restored or it is maximized, we are already in a web page which has an applet, and we moved from that web page to another web page in the next tab. So when we are coming back to the previous tab, it will call the start method. Okay. And the third method is the stop method. As the name indicates, it stop the applet executions. So when it executes, when an applet is minimized or when moving from one tab to another tab in the browser. So when we move from one tab to another tab, it call the stop method. Then we can move, when we came back from the another tab to the previous tab which has the applet program, then it calls the start method. Destroy. It executes when the applet window is closed or when the tab containing the web page is closed. So whether these two conditions, so if the applet window is closed, it will call the destroy. Otherwise, if we close the tab of the browser which contains the applet program, then also it calls the destroys, and at that time it removes the applet object from the memory. And paint. It is used to redraw the object of the applet display area. So everything which is displayed is written in this area, this method, and it executes after the start method. So we have mainly five methods in each: start, stop, destroy, and paint. In it is the beginning of an applet. So all the variable declarations, all the declarations are defined in the init method. Start, it is the body of the applet, So main the contents written in the main contents is written in the start method, then stop method. So when we move from one tab to another tab, or when we minimize the applet, it calls the stop method. Destroy, the end of the applet. So the applet object is removed from the memory after the destroy method is called. And paint, which is used to redraw the object applet to the display area. The applet display area is drawn by the paint. So let's look at a small example to understand about all these methods. So what in what sequence these methods are executed in the program. Okay, so let's move to the Eclipse. Okay, so we can run it. Okay, so this is a SAML program which has the init method, the start method, the stop method, and the paint method, and the destroy method. So all the five methods we have already discussed is written here. So look at the output. So we just run the applet. Look at the output. So applet is initialized, which means the init method is called. Applet execution started, which means the start method is also called. Then paint, the paint method is called. So first init method, then start method, then the paint method is called. So everything we have to redraw is written in the paint method. Okay, so next we can close the applet. So applet is closed. So we have discussed that after closing the applet, it will call the destroy method, right? Just look at that. Before the destroy method, it will call the stop method also, right? First stop method to stop the applet, then destroy method to remove it from the memory. Just look at the output. Yes, the execution stopped because it's called the stop method first, and then it is destroyed. So the last destroy method. So these three methods are executed in this sequence. First is initially init method, second one is the start method, third one is the paint method, and after closing the applet, it will execute the after closing or minimizing. Just look at it. If we minimize, whether it is called stop method, yeah, it is minimized, so it is called stop method that we discussed in the previous slide, right? So if it minimize, it will call the stop method. And if the restore, it will call the start method. Then again it moves to the painting, and when we close it, destroy it, right? So all these things we discuss. So once again, so applet is initialized, applet execution started. So when we minimize it, the applet execution is stopped. When we maximize it, the applet execution started, that is the start method, then the paint method, we close it. So all the methods are executed. So clear about the methods and how it is working in an applet, right? Okay, so this is a simple applet program. So as we studied about all the Hello World programs in different languages, we are also looking into the Hello World program in applet also. So every applet program, we have to import java.applet class, and we have to also import java.awt class because the graphics class is written there. So for these two classes are required to implement the Java applet. This Hello World applet is our program name, and we are extending the applet, and we have to write the paint method. So everything we want to draw is written in the paint method. So it is written in the paint method. And then draw string, which is equal to the printf statement in the system.out.println in the Java program. So if you want to write something into the applet, we have to use the draw string operation. This is a string we are going to write into the applet. This is the position. So the X position and the Y position where we are going to draw the object. So we are using a graphics object to write it on the graphics page. To use the graphics object, we have to import the java.awt. Okay. So next we can check how this program works in the Eclipse, right? So clear it. Hello world. Okay. Set the applet window size. So we are going to run the hello world applet. We have to set the spaces to 250. 250. It is the window size, the applet window size we are setting. Run it. So which displays an hello world app. So simple, right? So just we included java.applet package, java.awt package, and we have to write everything we have to display in the paint method. So this is the paint method. Paint method has an argument as graphics g object. Graphics is included in the awt package, and we are using the draw string to print the hello world in the output. Okay, next we can look into the this is the hello world.applet. Actually we displayed the result in the applet viewer in by using Eclipse, but if you want to display it in the browser, we have to use this code. But now it, the browsers are not supporting the applet anyway. This is the method which is available in the HTML4. In the HTML4 we have to write the applet tag to display the applet which we displayed by using the applet viewer. Okay, so this is the basic about the applet program. Before we wind up the lecture session, just do another interesting one. So this is a small applet program. This is a small music player by using the applet. A small music player by using an applet. Let's look how it runs. Okay. Can run it. So this is our program. So when we click this play button, it will play music. That's the program. So I can run it once again. So again I'm going to run this program. Click the play button. So this is implemented by using the Java applet. We'll study the details of this in the coming lectures, how we are going to implement all these activities in Java applet, which we'll discuss in the upcoming lectures. Okay, so thank you. Hope we'll get a basics of about the Java applets. Okay. Thank you.